Hi, I'm Chaplain Kuman. I'm with the 4th Battalion, 23rd Infantry Regiment, and this is Afghanistan.
Will you take what we have, a sacrifice unto you, then create clean hearts, and Lord, make our spirits new. Father, blessed Father, lead and guide us for your name's sake, and keep us in the shelter of your presence till we see your face. Let's know your voice and all of your ways. Take our hands, lead us home to the refuge that we find in you alone. Father, blessed Father, lead and guide us for your name's sake, and keep us Shepherd who carries us forevermore. Father, blessed Father, lead and guide us for your name's sake, and keep us in the shelter of your presence till we see your face. Father,
enjoyed the video. It gives you just a little bit of a taste of what it's like here in Afghanistan. We wanted to show you not only a little bit about where we go and what we do, but also a few more things I have for you. One is our store, where we bring all the supplies and all the hygiene products and books and magazines and food and cookies and all the candy and everything else that people supply us with, things that are very important to us, but also where we live, the FOB we live on, the forward operating base we live on, and the tents we stay in, where we eat, and where we go to worship, and where we shower, where we get our clothes washed, and where we do our work. And also, I stopped and just asked certain groups to say, hey, you mind saying thank you to the folks back home? So you're gonna catch that as we continue through the rest of this video. Here we are inside my tent, my office area, an area that we have also dedicated to storing all of the supplies that people have donated over the course of this deployment. Some toiletries here on the left, there's candy, there's coffee, and over here some more drink mixes. We got books, and then we got more food items and cookies and Girl Scout cookies and games. We have magazines up here, and we got flip-flops down there. We have writing paper, we have hats, things that people have donated. Okay, and here we have tents that are the command post for the various companies, some trucks and containers. These tents right in front of us here are the DFACT, the dining facility, and that's where we eat our breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Basically, this is where we have the food served to us. There's no food in here at the moment. It's quite simple. There's a hot plate to put in here. Let's go over here and take a look where we eat this bit. It's clean in here now, but in just another hour or so, soldiers will start pouring in here and helping themselves to some of the dessert that's on the table, grabbing a drink out of the cooler over there, and sitting down at the table and having a great meal. A wood building back there that was intended to be for the command, and now it's being used as a gym. And in this tent here we have MWR. MWR stands for Morale, Welfare, and Recreation. And in here we have soldiers who are communicating back home with the internet and with phones. Here's our chapel. The chapel is obviously a long tent. We built a wood face on it, wood front, so that it would stand out a little bit and have a little more attention. We see our worship area. We have couches to sit on and chairs to sit on with a large screen, and this is where we enjoy worshiping God. This is our shower tent, and all we have is these are our shower stalls and a place to do our changing. Beside the shower is the large, what we call bladder, water bladder. All of this this is our water we use for showering and washing clothes. Our generator, a large generator. Everything out here requires generation because we don't have electrical power without it. Okay, right now I'm gonna go get my laundry from our laundromat here, where soldiers turn their laundry in usually in the beginning of the morning, and by the end of the day they get their laundry back. Let's go take a look how this works. We just show our name on the paper here, they look at a number.
1120.
1120. All right. So, they just find us on here. And then we sign ourselves out.
Good.
Thank you very much.
You need to wear laundry.
Yes. See, they wash our laundry inside a bag. That way we don't have to worry about losing our laundry. And all the dirt just comes out through these holes. Exciting, huh? Okay, and here we have what we call the battalion headquarters area. This tent right here is the S1. S1 is basically all the administrative actions for soldiers is done in here. The second tent, called the S4 tent, and that's where all the supplies and that's where everything that we have to order logistically comes through. The next tent is where the battalion commander, Sergeant Major, live, and the next tent is where the battalion executive officer, the S3, that's operations, and the Sergeant Major, another Sergeant Major, live there. Then there's a briefing tent, then there's an operations tent where everything happens in this unit goes on that tent in terms of
operations and planning and missions. This is current operations where we monitor all of the activities within our battle space on the roads and in the air. These men look at monitors. We can't see all the monitors because the monitors contain classified information, sensitive information. They interpret the information and contact the people who need to know what's going on. They plan and coordinate for fires as well as transportation as well as everything else that needs to be done. The last tent over on the far right is where they decide what we're going to do in the future. It's called Future Ops, and in there they look at all the intelligence that they can find and all the intelligence that they can gather so that they can decide which targets are important targets, which things are important to them, and they put together a plan for future operations, and then they hand that to the people in current operations to decide what they're going to do. Here's a mine rolling device that they attach to some of the strikers. Usually when strikers roll out, they roll out three or four strikers at a time, and they usually like to have the first lead striker have one of these devices on it so that as it goes, if it hits a pressure plate in which it ignites a IED, the IED will blow up, and it will blow up on the actual mine roller. We've already had, I think, two or three mine rollers blown up on this deployment. Save people's lives. That's why we have this. Let's take a look at the rest of this striker. There's some pretty exciting things going on here. You can see the driver has a bulletproof glass case around where he rides. You see the armor on the side here, the slat armor. It's this stuff right here. It's designed to catch rocket-propelled grenades. And you can see this has been bent up, it's been hit, and it protects our soldiers. This vehicle has 8 wheels. It only needs 4 to operate. It can operate at, in all conditions. On the top is a machine gun called the 50 caliber, and it can reach way out. Specialist Richards here is the driver for this vehicle, and he's the one that's responsible to maintain it, keep it operating well, and make sure it's clean and ready to go. Some other things real quick we'll point out here is this, you see here, this little cage underneath. This is the exhaust area, and these steel plates on the top, they're exciting because it's a recent development just in the past few years. These plates, you can kind of see them, they're on an angle up there, and those are designed to keep the soldiers safe as they're driving down the road so that snipers cannot shoot them and easily injure them. Let's take a look at the back of this thing. Soldiers are getting ready to go on a mission. I'll be going out with them on this. It's a mail run. And but as you see here, there's like the tailgate drops down. Soldiers can come out of the back. And the netting on the top, to explain that real quick, is to keep the soldier's profile disguised from any would-be sniper or someone who wants to shoot at them so that they can't see our soldiers up there. Now the soldier can actually stand up in the rear guard hatch. I'll show you. Take a look. You can see the soldiers can have their weapons back here, and they can operate and protect everyone from the rear of the vehicle. Without taking too close of a look on the inside, this striker will hold 8 soldiers in the back and 3 in the front. Basically, it's 11 soldiers that can ride in the
vehicle. All you fine Americans back home, Rob coming to MGS Platoon. We want to say thank you for all the great things you've done for us this past year. The care package, letter of support. We just want to let you know how much we appreciate it.
Thank you!
This is 3rd Platoon Alpha Company, 423 Infantry, from beautiful, wonderful Helmand Province in Afghanistan. We'd just like to send the thanks out to everybody back home that has been sending us all the wonderful gifts, personal hygiene kits, the candies, socks, t-shirts, whatever the case is. We really do appreciate it, and it's hard for us to get to the PX and stuff like that to get resupplied. It's always like getting a Christmas present every day when it comes from y'all. So from the bottom of our hearts, we appreciate it. Thank you very much. Keep doing what you do.
We just want to say thank you very much. God bless you.